NASCAR on Fox welcomes you to the world center of speed, Daytona International Speedway. Just inland of Daytona Beach, where every 4th of July weekend since 1959, stock car faithful have come here with their beach balls and their flags. The event now known as the Pepsi 400. 43 Winston Cup drivers set to roll, set to join the ranks of five-time winner David Pearson, four-time champion of this race, Cale Yarborough, Bobby Allison, Richard Petty, Fireball Roberts, who each won it three times, four drivers with two victories and 17 with one apiece in this great summertime racing classic, which now races under the lights. Let's go to Speedway President John Graham.
And now, for the most famous words in motorsports, the Grand Marshal of the 44th Pepsi 400, Jessica Simpson.
Drivers, start your engines!
It's the traditional midpoint of the Winston Cup season. And amidst a tight point battle, any one of seven drivers could leave here with the point lead in what has traditionally been one of NASCAR's most unpredictable races. The Pepsi 400, next on Fox.
I remember I am walking down the street. I'm shooting all red with my boys and with my troops. And down along the avenue, some guys were shooting blues, and I heard the sound of acapella blues. Yeah. Singing late in the evening.
Summer in Dublin, Ohio, where you can count on two things, mosquitoes and garage sales.
You know that's one of a kind.
Half the town is buying.
This must be one of a kind.
And the other half is selling.
It's one of a kind.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to Daytona. Mike Joy with Larry McReynolds and three-time Winston Cup champ, Darrell Waltrip. Cale Yarborough led all but 18 laps in winning here. Jimmy Spencer led just the last lap. Cale won this race by two laps. Bill Elliott won it by 18 inches. It's so unpredictable, and it's so much fun, Darrell, except maybe for those 43 drivers out there. They haven't had a lot of practice, and it's Daytona. It's restrictor plate racing.
What's that song? Are y'all ready for this? Because that's exactly how I feel. The thing about it is, you've got to get up there and get amongst them. And these cars have not had any drafting practice. So there's setup issues. There's handling issues. There's all kind of issues that we're going to have to sort out in the early going. But the biggest problem is you don't want to get in trouble doing until you get those things sorted out.
So, Larry, how do you sort them out without the benefit of any drafting practice after qualifying?
Well, I mean, I love your word unpredictable, but from a crew chief standpoint, I'm going to go with the word unknown. Like Darrell said, these cars have not been on the racetrack since they qualified. Can you go back to last year's notes from a year ago? No. The rules are different. Can you go back to your Daytona notes? Yes, you can, but this track is much slicker in the hot temperatures here in July. So you basically, you throw your best package at it from your February notes, but you know you have to make adjustments. But I can't tell my driver, feel it out, because if you feel it out, they're going to be laughing you pretty quick here. You can't back off.
If you want a night of unpredictable action, you've come to the right place. Let's go trackside to Steve Burns.
Mike, Jeff Gordon has four wins here at Daytona. He's one of five drivers that could win a $1 million bonus if he can win. Well, crew chief Robbie Loomis says they've taken this number 24 car to the wind tunnel not once but twice for a total of 16 hours at $2,000 an hour. Do the math. They want to win this $1 million bonus. Let's go to... It's Dick Bergeron.
Yeah, but to win it, they're going to have to beat Dale Earnhardt Jr. During driver introductions, this audience went absolutely berserk when his name was mentioned. He is the favorite. He has won three of the last four restrictor plate races. He's smart. He's cool. He's extra good at places like this. To Matt Yocum.
Dick, the last time Pontiac
Pontiac won a points-paying race at Daytona. Ronald Reagan was running for re-election. Tony Stewart has two Budweiser shootout victories. But remember, tonight he's racing with a couple unknowns. He only completed two laps back in the Daytona 500 with engine failure. They've gone back to their 500 notes without any final practice session, but they're still unsure how those notes will react tonight because they only had two laps back in February. Mike?
Budweiser, official beer of NASCAR, is proud sponsor of the Bud Pole Award, given to the fastest qualifier at every NASCAR Winston Cup race. Kevin Harvick is a first-time Bud Pole winner, and he joins these other drivers in the Bud Shootout of 2003. Since 1979, Anheuser-Busch has awarded more than $7 million as title sponsor of NASCAR's Pole Award program. Let's move to our Walmart starting grid. Kevin Harvick, first pole, and Jeffrey Bodine in only his third start of the season, former Daytona 500 winner, on the front row. Jeff Gordon, two-time winner of this race. Robbie Gordon, no relation, looking for his first restrictor plate triumph. Dale Jarrett has four Daytona wins. Johnny Benson, top 10 in February, led a lot of it. Michael Waltrip, four top fives in the last six restricted races with his teammate Steve Park and his teammate Dale Earnhardt Jr., who we've talked about right behind, along with the fastest Dodge in the field, young Casey Atwood. Veterans Bobby Hamilton and Ricky Rudd, looking for his first Daytona triumph. Mike Wallace with Bill Elliott, a four-time Daytona winner. Kenny Wallace and Jimmy Johnson, the pole winner, fastest qualifier back in February here. Brett Bodine, ninth last July, and Mark Martin, one of those Noble Million bonus cars. Ken Schrader has 20 top 10s at Daytona, and Sterling Marlin, the point leader. Bobby Labonte, fifth here last July, and Kyle Petty, fresh off that 3,500-mile charity ride. Mike Skinner won both Daytona poles in 97, and Todd Bodine, who competed last night in the Busch race. Jimmy Spencer, who won this race in 94, leading only the last lap, and Ricky Craven, another no-bull car. Shauna Robinson, the only female in the field, and Kurt Busch, who was fourth in the Daytona 500. Tony Stewart, just two laps in February here, but he has two top tens, and Dave Blaney in a Ford. Elliott Sadler, third here last July after starting 38th with John Andretti in a Petty Dodge. Stacy Compton's Pontiac and Hunt Strickland's Dodge in row 17. Jeff Burton, the 2000 winner of this race, and Terry Labonte, two-time series champion. Then the provisional starters. Rusty Wallace has not won Daytona in 38 starts, maybe tonight. And Matt Kenseth, another no-bull car. Ryan Newman in the same car. He raced to seventh here. And Jeff Green. Ward Burton, the Daytona 500 champion, had trouble with the cowl intake in qualifying. He's there with Jeremy Mayfield, a pair of Dodges. And last night's winner, tonight he's last row Joe Nemechek, an unexpected spot, but he anchors the field. 43 cars, 160 laps, 400 miles, 100 miles less than we race in February.